الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد، الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد، الله أكبر.
جزاكم خير. الحمد لله. طيب again I'm repeating for the overflow.
استقيموا واستووا. يعني ان شاء الله we're going to pray صلاة العيد as you know ما شاء الله after تكبيرة الإحرام we make 7 تكبيرات in the first ركعة then we recite الفاتحة and surah as usual in other prayers then in the second ركعة ان شاء الله after the تكبيرة moving from sujood to the second ركعة we make 5 تكبيرات then the rest of صلاة is as usual may Allah accept from all of us جزاكم الله خيرا. الله أكبر. 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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. 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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية؟ وجوه يومئذ خاشعة، عاملة ناصبة، تصلى نارا حامية، تسقى من عين آنية، ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع، لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع، وجوه يومئذ ناعمة، لسعيها راضية، في جنة عالية، لا تسمع فيها لاغية، فيها عين جارية، فيها سرر مرفوعة، وأكواب موضوعة، ونمارق مصفوفة، وزرابي مبثوثة. أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت، وإلى السماء كيف رفعت، وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت، وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت. فذكر إنما أنت مذكر، لست عليهم بمسيطر، إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر. إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Assalamu alaikum. If you are parking in Rona or parking in the anywhere except the medical building and the two buildings, please go and get your car. Jazakum Allah khair. Only the medical building and the one, and today only.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa Allah, Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام وكفى بها من نعمة. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. All praise and thanks are due to Allah for the blessing of Islam. And we ask Allah جل وعلا to accept from our brothers and sisters who are performing great عبادة of Hajj. And I ask Allah جل وعلا to grant all of us inshallah an accepted Hajj in the coming years. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. The connection between the rituals we perform as Muslims generally and especially in these days and our life, our day-to-day life is very deep, and every Muslim should ponder these connections to get the most of his ibadah. You know, acts of worship in Islam are meant to have a real impact on our life. It's not just something we perform and it's completely separated from our life. And today, inshallah, we are going to reflect on some of the great lessons we should learn from the events and rituals we perform as Muslims in these days. First of all, and I think this is the most important, everything about these rituals performed in Hajj and the connection between these rituals and the story of our father Ibrahim alayhi salam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's all about submitting to Allah jalla wa ala. Total submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to make the story short, we all know the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. After a very long time, Allah Jalla Ala blessed him with his son Ismail. And after this, immediately Allah Jalla Ala ordered Ibrahim to take his newborn son and his mother to the desert and to leave them there. And Ibrahim, without questions, submitted to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when he took them and left them there, we know that his wife was following him, running after him. Oh Ibrahim, why are you leaving us here? And to whom you are leaving us here? And he didn't answer until she understood. And she said, has Allah commanded you to do so? And he said, yes. Then she said, then Allah will not lead us astray. And the story continues. And after Ibrahim alayhi salam, after a few years, and Ismail reach an age like he became a young man, and Allah Jalla Ala say, فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعْهُ السَّعْيَ, when he reached the age to work with his father, Allah Jalla Ala ordered Ibrahim to slaughter his son Ismail. And he want to discuss this with his son. He knows that he saw this in his dream, and what, it's not right, like a dream. Like we know that the dreams of prophets and messengers are revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he told his son Ismail that he saw this night vision and told him, what do you think about this? And Ismail told him, oh father, oh dear father, do as you were commanded. And subhanallah, Allah Jalla described this moment when Ibrahim alayhi salam was about to slaughter his Ismail to fulfill the order of Allah Jalla Ala. Allah Jalla described this with his beautiful words, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَ, when they submitted to the will of Allah Jalla Ala. And actually everything about the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam is to teach us submission to Allah Jalla Ala. This is the core of Islam. And if we do not submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means that we are not truly Muslims. And by the way, submitting to Allah jalla ala is the reasonable thing to do, is the logical thing to do. And we do practice submission to all types of authority in our lives. We submit to our doctors, to our lawyers. We submit to so many authorities in our life. Because we know we cannot do it all. We cannot handle everything. No one knows everything. And we find it easy, once you choose a very good doctor, to submit to this doctor. He tells you what to eat, what to drink, what sort of medicine should you take, how to live your life basically. And because you trust this authority, you submit to it. It's the same with lawyers, with accountants, with every other authority in our life. Why do we find it very difficult to submit to the will of Allah Jalla wa'ala? Is anyone better than Allah Jalla wa'ala? Will anyone care more for you than Allah Jalla wa'ala? Does any of these people has more knowledge and wisdom than Allah Jalla wa'ala? Why do we find it difficult to submit to Allah Jalla wa'ala? If it's difficult for us, it means that we need to question our iman, and we need to work more and more to attain the core of Islam, which is submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. One of the beautiful things about Islam, subhanallah, the two Eids we have, Allah Jalla Ala made these two Eids right after two great ibadat. Eid al-Fitr after Ramadan, after fasting, and Eid al-Adha after Hajj. For us to learn that there is no real happiness in this life or in the other life except if we follow the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot achieve real happiness, peace of mind, tranquility, and you cannot survive in the Day of Judgment, and you cannot win the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except if you follow the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Someone might ask, you know, the whole Ummah fast in Ramadan, then the whole Ummah celebrate Eid al-Fitr after Ramadan. But in Hajj, not the whole Ummah perform Hajj. Just group of the Ummah. People from every corner of the Ummah go to the same place to perform the same rituals in the same time. Why the whole Ummah is celebrating? Because it's one Ummah. The whole Ummah is performing Hajj if group of Ummah is performing Hajj. And the whole Ummah celebrate after Hajj because we are one Ummah. Subhanallah, this is the way. If you went to Hajj, if you went to Umrah, you will find that a lot of people from everywhere around the world, different colors, different tongues, different backgrounds, and all are the same. All are acting like one Ummah, like Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. مثل المؤمنين في توديهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم مثل الجسد الواحد. The believers in their mutual kindness, compassion and sympathy are like one body. If one of the limbs suffer, the whole body will respond to it with feverness, with fever and wakefulness. Subhanallah, so it's one ummah. And I don't know, like one of the worst trap the ummah fall into, like in the last two centuries, that we think we are not one Ummah anymore. We truly believe in the fake borders that divide us as one Ummah. So some people, they only care if the problem is happening in their country based on the fake borders that were drawn by the enemies of the Ummah. And I know a lot of people, subhanallah, they think, Alhamdulillah, this is not happening in Egypt. Alhamdulillah, this is not happening in this place. Alhamdulillah, this is happening in other place. It's not happening in other place. It's happening to you. Whatever happens in Sudan, it happens to you directly. It's your place. It's your ummah. Subhanallah, it's like if someone's trying to sell the idea, Alhamdulillah, Vancouver is not from Canada. So you as Canadians shouldn't be worried if Vancouver was invaded and the enemies started killing all the citizens of Vancouver. We feel bad as human, but you know what? Vancouver is not Canada. Alhamdulillah, this is not happening in Canada. It's very absurd. It's not real. It's fake idea. It's the same, subhanAllah, with our ummah. I don't know how can we as Muslim accept that, like Muslims in Egypt or Muslims in any country near to Gaza now or any country near to Sudan right now, how can we accept to live our lives thinking, oh, alhamdulillah, this is happening in Palestine. This is happening in Sudan. It's not happening to us. Alhamdulillah, may Allah protect Egypt. Alhamdulillah, this is not happening to Egypt. It's happening to you. What is Egypt? What is Sudan? It's just names, fake borders. And it's not actually a permanent thing. You know what Sudan used a few years ago? Used to be one country, now it's two countries. Maybe people in south of Sudan now say, alhamdulillah, this is not happening in our country. The same country they used to believe that this is the same country. So we shouldn't fall into this trap. This is not real. This is not real. Allah Jalla Ala will hold us accountable because whatever happened in any place of this ummah is our responsibility. It's our duty at least to feel and for everyone to do whatever we can do. But the idea that we believe that this is different country, this idea that permits someone who lives few kilometers from kids are being slaughtered. People are being bombarded. And you feel, alhamdulillah, this is not happening to us. It's happening to you. And if it's not happening directly to you now, it will happen to you very soon. This whole idea of nationalism and the modern countries and the borders that divide the ummah, it's not real. And we shouldn't fall into this. It is one ummah. And we are going to be accountable to the judgment. According to this, it is one ummah, it's our responsibility. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa Allah, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. One of the greatest ibadat to be performed in these days, apart from Udhiyya Qurbani, Takbir, in the first 10 days of the Hajj, Takbir saying Allahu Akbar. It's a great ibadah because this word, Allahu Akbar, is actually very important and very needed in our life. You know, Allahu Akbar, it doesn't translate to God is the greatest. No, it's translated to Allah is greater. It's an open sentence. God is greater than what? God is greater than everything and everyone, anything you can think of, God is greater than this thing. And if we truly, while saying Allahu Akbar, we say it in our prayers every day throughout our life, you say it Allahu Akbar in Salah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And especially in these days, this should change the mentality of Muslim. This should change the mentality of a believer to put Al-Akhirah first. Because Allah is greater than this life. To not have this sort of conflict between obeying Allah Jalla Ala and doing whatever I want to do in my life. Because God is greater. We shouldn't have any conflict between doing what Allah Jalla Ala wants from us to do and our desires. Because whenever we have this conflict, we remember that Allah is greater. We directly go with the greater. If we are scared to stand with haqq, to say the truth, to stand our ground and defend the right, the truth. We remember that Allah is greater than our oppressors. Allah is greater than anyone we might fear. Allah is great. Allah Jalla Ala is the one who controls everyone and everything. Allah Jalla Ala is the one who provides, the true provider, the true sustainer, the one who gives life and the only one who can take life. So God is greater. It is it is an idea that should control every decision we make in our life. So next time when we say Allahu Akbar, we should remember this. And this should fix everything in our life. At least this should help us to make the right decision in order to please Allah Jalla wa Ala and to live this life with dignity, without compromising our religion, without giving away our principles and what we believe in. Knowing that it is everything is in the hand of Allah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. Ask Allah جل وعلا for this Eid to be a happy Eid on the whole Ummah, especially our brothers and sisters in Gaza, in Palestine, in Sudan, everywhere in the Ummah. May Allah جل وعلا give them victory. May Allah جل وعلا make it easy for them. May Allah جل وعلا give them steadfastness and strength to face the oppression, to face the genocide, to face the lies, to face the hypocrites and traitors. And I ask Allah جل وعلا to enable us to help them and to support them. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت على الحق أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وكل عام وأنتم بخير، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Assalamu alaikum. Inshallah, we have hands for charity on the farm. Inshallah, if you want to donate to our people in Palestine, we have for under 14, we have 2 bags. And if you go left more, we have ice cream.
Just one comment, please. If you parked in Rona or parked in any place except the 2 buildings and the 1 medical, please go ahead to your car. Jazakum Allah khair.
في ناس حتى في رونا في اي ان دبليو
اتسحب
قلت لهم،
بس هي المشكله عارف الظريف ان هم جم التوينج ما شافهمش.
التوينج عليكم العام بخير. الله خير، ثانك يو، تقبل الله منا منكم ورزاكم خير.
التوينج مش قادر يسحب.
كل عام بخير.
الله يبارك. السلام عليكم، العام بخير.
روحت التليفون بتاع الزلم. السلام عليكم،
الله عليكم بخير. كل عام بخير. صحه وسلامه.
الله يبارك منك، الله يجزاك الله منا ومنكم، الله يحفظك ويسعدك يا رب. السلام عليكم، كل عام وانتم بخير. مي الله.